everyone, I'm Dr. Litawadi Zuhabun from Pharmaceutical Department. So today we're gonna do lab experiment in the course of Medical Biochemistry PCS60211. So today we're gonna do a spectrophotometer lab experiment. First of all, I would like to introduce the equipment and the important material for use in this lab. So as you can see, we have like three types of equipment. The first one I want to show you, this called the tip. So tip is, we have two types of tip. First one is the small one in yellow color. So this tip for like 200 microliter. The second one is for 1 milliliter or 1 ml. So you can see at the blue color. Another thing, we have two types of pipette. So the first one for the 200 microliter, we have 200 pipette. So this pipette gonna match with this tip. And the second one for 1 ml, this pipette, you can see the scale, this one. So this pipette gonna match with this tip for 1 ml. So I know this is the online course, so it's difficult to like practice by yourself, but you need to concern the equipment for use in the lab. Because when you go to another course, you need to use this by yourself. And another thing for the lab, the common one we have the DI water. And another one, the glass lab, I think you already know it, like bigger or the tube, small tube. And the important thing for this lab, we're gonna use the spectrophotometer so we can move to this side. So this is for 1 microliter or 1 ml pipette. So you can see this the size from 100 microliter to 1 ml, this one. So if you want to change the volume, this is the 1000 microliter or 1 ml. So the scale is 100. So if you want to adjust to 500 microliter, you need to screw down like this. This is 600. This is 500. So you can see 050. So the lowest that you can use for this one is to 100. Yeah, this is for 100 microliter. So you cannot use for lower this one because it inaccurate. And another one, this is 200 microliter. So you can see the scale. This can use for 20 to 200 microliter. And don't forget this for this tip, the yellow one. So if you want to change the volume, the maximum is 200, and then you can scroll down. Like if you want 150, you need scroll down to 150. This is 150. So the lowest that you can use for this pipette is 20. So the scale for 20 is this 50, 50, 40, 30, and 20. So actually you can see the small, the thing that can point the scale. If you scroll down than 20, it's inaccurate because they already mentioned this pipette can use for 20 to 200. So you need to be careful about it. This is spectrophotometer, so you can see the channel in this screen. We have two channels. The first one is for wavelength. So in this case, you can see the wavelength of 546 nanometer. And the second channel is for absorbance. So you can see this is zero absorption, so it means it's no absorption.
the below one, this for the mode for select wavelength. If you want to increase wavelength, you can put this one. For example, if I increase, you can see the wavelength increase to like 568 from 566, right? And this one for like decrease wavelength. For example, if I put down like this, so this go down to like 544. And another one is for like set up the blank. First of all, for the spectrophotometer lab, you need to set blank. Every measurement you need to like blank off all of material. So if I zero this one, you can see the screen view appear setting blank. So after that, you can see the absorption will read to zero. So next, we move to the second part. This very important part for you. This for like we put the qubit in this part. So you can see this the channel for qubit. And first of all, when you use spectrophotometer, you need to see the direction that you want to put the qubit in the channel. So you can see the sign. This is the path of from light. If you remember in the lecture, this part of the light, salt light in here. For UV, the salt light is tungsten, right? And then the light will come through this part, move from here to here. So it makes sense that you, when you put the qubit in this part, you need to like put the qubit from the right part of qubit from here to here, like this. And not only spectrophotometer, you need to know another thing that you need to know is the type of qubit. So if you remember, I teach you like we have like three type of qubit, right? So the first one is the plastic qubit, this one. So the material is made from plastic. The second one actually the shape it should like this one, but in this case we don't have it. The second one is called glass qubit. So glass qubit, the material also made from glass. And we have like the shape like this and this also. So this one for another spectrophotometer. And the last one, this quartz qubit. So quartz qubit quite expensive. When you use quartz, you need to be careful because it costs like 1,000 or like 10,000 baht. So quartz, you can see they have like size Q in this one, because someone maybe like confused between quartz and glass. So it's quite similar. And then now you already know the three type of qubit, right? And then I need to show you all of Thai, they have like two sides of qubit. The first side is like clear. If you see, it's quite clear. And the second side is quite like unclear. It's same. If you see this quartz qubit and this plastic qubit. For plastic qubit, this the size of clear in here. And as you remember, I already mentioned you need to put the right side in the right part when you use spectrophotometer. So need to remember the light will pass through the solution in from the clear side of qubit, not this one. Not this unclear side. So should be clear side. So remember when you put the solution in here and you need to measure in spectro, you need to move the clear side and match to the light part, this one, like this. This is the right one. The light part will pass through the clear part of qubit. But if you move to the unclear part and put in the wrong one, if you see this unclear, and the light will come from right here. If you put this, it's wrong, because the light cannot move from the unclear part. So when you read in absorption, it's incorrect. And next, I'm gonna introduce you the material or the solution that we wanna use in this lab. If you you already know, we have two experiments. The first one, we need to measure the maximum absorbance of potassium permanganate. So the first part, I will use 0.05 gram per liter of potassium permanganate. So this is gonna use for find the maximum absorption of potassium permanganate. And the second part, we will find out the calibration curve. So we're gonna use a standard of potassium permanganate at 0.1 gram per liter. And we will detect the unknown concentration. So we have two unknown, unknown 2 and unknown 9. These are also potassium permanganate, but we don't know the concentration. If you remember, we from the first one, we already know the concentration of permanganate. But in unknown case, we don't know the concentration. So you need to find out the concentration of unknown from the second part of a standard curve. And the important thing when you do experiment, you need to concern the material or solution that the scientist prepared for you. You can observe they already wrapped with the plastic with dark color. So you need to think about this, why they wrap with the dark one. I'm gonna tell you because the potassium permanganate, this is light sensitive solution. So if you not wrap for or protect the light, it's gonna degrade. So the first experiment, we're gonna find out the maximum absorbance of potassium permanganate. I'm gonna use DI water for set blank. So I already put water into the beaker, and then you will use pipette the water into cuvette. And the pipette, they have like two steps. The first one, you need to press down or pipette, and then inject the solution into the tip. So you can see the solution already into the tip, and then put into cuvette. So this how to put release the solution into cuvette. They have like two steps. The first one, you already decrease this one. And then they have like small parts of solution in the tip. So you need to put down again. This is the second step, like this. So this create they don't have the solution in the tip. I will put this two more times because we have 3 mL. This is the second time. Move this one, and then we release, and then we press down again. This is the third time. Okay, now we got the blank. And don't forget, you need to conserve the clear side when you put into instrument. And another thing, you need to clean up the cuvette before put in the spectrophotometer. This is the clear side. And then after you already set 450 nanometer, you can press to 0 ABS. It means the auto zero. So if you see, if we don't set blank, the absorption will reach 0.6. So we don't need this. So we need to auto zero it. You can see it's the instrument setting the blank. And then this is already done. At wavelength 450 nanometer, the absorption will read as zero already. Then we're gonna use standard potassium permanganate at 0.05 gram per liter for find out the maximum absorption. So we will use 3 mL, the same with blank. 1 ml. Two ml. And the last one. So don't forget this, the clear side. This and clear. And then clean up it again. And then put into spectrum. You can read at wavelength 450 nanometer, the absorption is 0.149. So after the first one, you need to like put it out, and I want you to repeat it like all of these three times. So we already done for the first time, and then second time, you need to measure again and read absorption again. So the second time, we can read absorbance as 0.150. And then move it on again. And then the last one, the third. And read it again. So the final one is also the same with second one, 0.150. So now you got the three time. At wavelength 50 nanometer. So from this absorption, we like 0.149 and 0.150 and 0.150. So these three volume you need to like average it at the 450 nanometer. So you get the volume of absorbent at 450 nanometer. Then second wavelength we need to increase to 475. So when you change the wavelength, you need to set up the bank every time. Don't forget about it. So I will put the bank again. And then auto zero. Yeah, this is already zero. And then measure the potassium permanganate standard. And then read at 475 nanometer. So the absorbent at this wavelength is 0.233. So this is the first one. And then you change to the second one because I need three times, right? So this is the second one. The second one is 0.233. And then the final one. The final one is the same, 0.233. Okay, then we move to the third wavelength, 500 nanometer. And then same with the two wavelength before, you need to set up zero again. It is auto zero at 500 nanometer. And then read the absorbance of potassium permanganate. So this 0.443. This is the first one. And then second one. 0.443. And the final one. 0.443. Then we move to 525 nanometer. First, sit blank. Auto zero. The first time. So absorption at 455 nanometer is 0.684. Second time. 0.679. The final one. 0.684. Then we move to 550 nanometer. Okay, set bang again. Auto zero. And then this for time. So the absorption is 0.607. Second time. 0.613. The last one is 0.612. Then we move to the 575. And then set bang. So first time is 0.286. Second time, 0.291. The last one, 0.291. Okay, then we move to the final wavelength at 600 nanometer. So we set blank again. Zero. So the absorption is 0.063. The second one is 0.067. The last one, 0.064. Okay, now you already got the absorb band in all wavelength. So I want you to like plot the spectrum of potassium permanganate. The exit of X is the wavelength and the exit of Y is OD or absorb band. So you need to like average in each wavelength. So I already conclusion, as you can see, the maximum wavelength of potassium permanganate is at the wavelength at 525 nanometer, because you can read the highest absorption in this wavelength. So we're gonna use this wavelength to another the second experiment to find out standard curve. Then we move to the second experiment. This experiment, I want to find out standard curve and find out concentration of unknown. So first of all, you need to prepare standard solution, right? So this is the tube. I already prepared the tube for make standard solution of potassium permanganate. If you see in direction lab, I want you to prepare like 5 or 6, 5 concentration. So you prepare the tube and label the tube from number two, right? Number two, and then you need to write the number in the tube. This is the trick of the every experiment. You need to label the instrument. 2, 3. and then 4, 5, 6. After you prepare the tube, you need to adjust the prepare the standard solution. Third one is you need to put 0.2 potassium permanganate. So we're gonna use potassium permanganate standard from 0.1 gram per liter, and then we dilute the series of standard solution by we use the eye water for dissolve the potassium permanganate. I'm gonna show you for the one concentration of potassium permanganate at number 6. So at number 6 of standard solution, you need to put 1.6 ml of potassium permanganate. So check the pipette again, this one. And here potassium permanganate. Okay, this one I put into the tube, test tube. And we need more 600 microliters. So now in test tube, you already put 1.6 ml of potassium permanganate. Then you need to change the tip, because you need to adjust the volume of the eye water to 3 ml, right? So you need to put 1.4 ml of water into the test tube. So the water, and this 1 ml. And we need more 400 microliters. This 400. So now you got the standard solution of the number 6 concentration permanganate, right? So you can see the color like it. And then you made another one from number 2, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the, I already made it for you. Number 2, number 3, 4, 5, and 6. So as you can see, the color will be increased. It means the concentration of potassium permanganate increased, right? So now we got 5 concentration of potassium permanganate, and then we're gonna measure by spectral photometer to make standard curve. Don't forget, every time when you use spectral photometer, you need to set brand, right? So the brand should be water. So you put water into the cuvette. Okay. And now from experiment 1, you already know the maximum absorption of potassium permanganate is 525 nanometer. So you need to change the wavelength to 525 nanometer. Okay, and then put the brand into the chamber. Don't forget put the clear sign into the light part. And then auto zero. You need to wait until the absorption shows zero. Now it already zero. Then you measurement the standard solution from the lowest concentration of potassium permanganate, because if you start from the highest concentration, it will cause error. I will start from number 2. the color rate of potassium permanganate. And then rate of absorption. So the third one, the from standard number 2, you're gonna read the absorbance at 0.098. And then move to the third one. We're gonna use the same qubit because to prevent the error from the qubit. So in order to make more the accuracy, you need to like rinse with the same solution into qubit. And then throw it away. And then put the right one again. So the third one is the absorbance is 0.171. Now I move to the third one or number 4. So don't forget to rinse or to clean the qubit again because we change concentration. The absorbance at number 4 standard solution is 0.251. Number 5 standard solution absorbent is 0.346. And the last one. The last one is 0.753. So now you already measurement all of 5 standard solution of potassium permanganate. Now you can make standard curve. So I want you to plot the standard curve. The axis of x is the concentration of potassium permanganate. So you need to calculate because you start from the standard solution of potassium permanganate. 0.1 gram per liter, and then you pipette different volume of potassium permanganate in different standard solution. So you need to calculate. The method to calculate, I already lectured in slide. We're gonna use the C1V1 equal to C2V2. So you got the concentration of potassium permanganate in each tube of standard solution. This is the volume for x axis, and then for y axis, you plot the absorbance that you read from each tube. Okay, now I think you're gonna got the standard curve already. Then the last one, we need to measurement the unknown concentration because from period one, we already got standard curve. The standard curve, I will use this one for calculate the concentration of unknown. But first of all, you need to measurement the unknown absorbance. As I already mentioned, we have two unknown, unknown 2 and 9. So I will measurement the concentration of unknown at the same wavelength. I start with number 2 unknown. So unknown number 2, the absorbance is 0.222. And then unknown number 9. Absorbance of unknown number 9 is 0.510. So now the experiment was done. In every experiment, now you got the concentration of unknown. You got standard curve, and you know how to measurement the maximum absorption of solution. In this case, we use potassium permanganate. So I think you're gonna calculate the unknown concentration and send me the report again. I will upload the schedule in e-learning. See you.